Good morning, Willow Creek fans. This is Tony, and we're over in Preston Forest again for our next sale, and we're very excited about it. We're going to be calling this one Beautiful on Buckingham, and you're going to see why. But before I start off, I just want to let everyone know that this house is for sale, and the house is with a realtor by the name of Carol Pitt. So if you're looking for a really great house that has a master on the main, this would be a house that you definitely want to look at in a really great neighborhood. So Karen, you want to say hi to everybody?
Good morning.
So we're going to go inside. And just to let you all know, none of the pots out here are for sale. So they're staying with the house.
They are pretty though. I'm blind now.
So before we go through this house, this truly is a downsizing situation. So there's a lot of beautiful things that have been left in the home. However, they are truly taking a lot of the items to where they're moving to. So if you'll follow me, we'll go through the living room first. So we do have a collector of some blue and white for all those blue and white fans. You're going to see some blue and white. You'll see some beautiful Chinese oriental lamps here, which has a carving on them. It looks like a dragon. Really nice. This is absolutely a great piece of furniture. It does have a little issue with one leg, but it's an early piece. Probably 1850s. Probably had the hardware replaced, but a very, very good piece. And then, Karen, if you'll show them up here, these are Remington prints, and they're actually signed by Remington, and they are also artist-proof. So those prints, we have six of those in this estate, and they're hung up throughout the estate. This is actually a live plant, believe it or not. I thought it was artificial at first, but it is a live plant. We have a little old-timey rocker there.
It's the little things that gets him excited.
It does. And we have a little chair here that's been embroidered.
It's a cute chair.
It is. It's a very different shape. It's almost like a triangle shape. A little boat there that you could put something in. A mirror. Another little neat chair. And then I'm going to stop right here. This is a press. We're trying to find out the history on it, possibly from Greene County. Not sure at this moment, but it's really super old. And it's in excellent shape for the amount of age that is on this piece. So we are going to do a little bit more homework. So hopefully when you come tomorrow morning, we will know a little bit more about this piece. Once again, Karen, if you want to pan around, you see some gorgeous blue and white lamps. We do have an old piece of Staffordshire, but it is cracked. It has been re-glued. And this is a neat little table. We're using it right now as a console table. You could use it as a desk. You could do all kinds of neat things with this table. Over here we have some furniture. This furniture basically is brand new. It hasn't been really used. The little gray, I would say it's a gray blue type sofa. Beautiful little gray chair that goes along with it. And then this wrought iron table with, for those who like to collect the Vaseline glass, we have three or four pieces there. This is a lift chair.
Let me show them these prints.
Sure. There's more of those Remington prints. I also have some that are not framed, which I'll show you here in a few minutes. But this is a lift chair. It is in excellent condition. It's brand new and it does work. So for those folks looking for a lift chair, maybe me, Sammy. You might want to show them this little table here. I think it's kind of neat with the blue and white and a few pieces like that. So in the kitchen here, we have these handmade presses that used to be stamps that you would have put ink on and do that with them. The person actually hung them up and put them on the wall. So I thought that was kind of neat. We have some pottery here.
A few pieces.
And then what I was talking about is we have a lot of old prints that are numbered that were bought several years ago. And like I said, here is, if you'll see, this is an artist proof. I don't want to destroy this, but this is an artist proof done by Remington and actually signed by him. So there's a limited number of these. So if you're into cowboys, into that old Western art, this might be something you'd like to look at. We have a neat little table here. It's solid oak. We have two leaves for it. We only have four chairs that go along with it. It also has a nice little set of dishes on top of it. It's an eight-piece serving of dishes. And then, Karen, I don't know that we need to go outside, but we do have some outside furniture here, some really nice, been taken care of. The fire pit as well is for sale. And this is a gas grill that you're able to actually hook up to your gas line at your home. So if you're looking for a good grill, this might be something you would want to take a look at. This is Melba Moore. She's a local artist. I have about four or five of her works throughout the house. So if you like that type of look, some of that folky art, a couple of pieces appear to look really good. This is Mexico. These are all handmade in Mexico. There's actually a set of eight that goes with this set. These are just actually hung on the wall. And then in our kitchen, we just have a variety of glass items. These little mugs are kind of cute. They're Tom and Jerry. They appear to be relatively old. And then there's a whole a bowl that goes with them that matches. So
is that like a punch bowl?
It appears to be a punch bowl set, something like that. A few cookbooks, most of them they took with them because, like I said, the family is downsizing. Once again, we have a Lennox set here, and it's just a few pieces. It's a platter, a coffee creamer, and things like that. So you would bring it out just for like a little coffee service time. A few pots and pans, like I said, downsizing, those type of things. Some cookie cutters. We do have one old cookie cutter there.
No appliances are for sale, correct?
None are for sale. These are neat. These are quite old. These are from Currier. If any of you all have seen his works, he works for different like calendars and things like that. And you can see where these were engraved. And this is a really neat set. The great thing about it is every single one of these pictures are different on the plates. So you have a railroad picture here, for example, and some teacups. These are salt cellars, and I have the sterling silver spoons to go with them. I'm not leaving them out. So if you decide you would like a salt cellar set, I will be more than happy to get the spoons for you. Very old plate, probably late 1800s, or probably early 1800s. They're saying circa 1820 is when this plate was made. So it's a beautiful piece of porcelain that has survived. I think that's it, Karen. We'll head this way to the dining room.
Before you go to the dining room, you want to talk a little bit about where we're checking out at? Because this is going to be a little bit different because it's going to be freezing cold tomorrow, people.
Yes, so Karen's taking care of everybody. So this is actually the master bedroom, and they took the furniture, so we're actually going to check out in this room. We do have a TV up here for sale, by the way. You might show them that. Actually, in this house, we have two flat-screen TVs. As far as I know, they are not smart TVs, but they appear to be in excellent condition.
And are you going to have them come in the front door, or?
They will be coming in through the garage.
Okay. All right. So this is the garage. The dryer is not for sale.
Yeah, the dryer is for sale. It is a gas dryer.
Okay.
And it is for sale. So if you have gas appliances at your house and need a gas dryer, it is got some age on it, but it's working. I made sure of that. So, and you know how it is during this period of time when they're making dryers and washing machines, they last forever. We do have a relatively new washing machine that...
They're both Whirlpool, right?
Yes, both are Whirlpool. Okay. Of course, we have some picture frames there. So we're going to go into the dining room. This is a really neat dining room set. It is chrome. I'm sure that she paid a lot for it. And it's one of those sets that I think you could either set outside or actually use it for a dining room in your house.
It is really cool.
It's kind of ultra-modern. It's really neat. And then, we have a mirror set. We have two, these two go with it. And as you'll see on the table, we have two candlesticks that go with it. Karen wanted me to decorate for Christmas. So ho, ho, ho. These are actually handmade plates, kind of by Studio 33. There's three designs that go with them. So if you're looking at some funky Christmas pattern for your table this year, they're priced well. Make sure you look them up. We do have this beautiful crystal punch bowl. It's absolutely in excellent condition, no chips on it. And it's got that almost, I would call it the American Brilliance type look. These are marble, and they're quite heavy, so it's going to take some weight to lift those. They've got a really unique look to them, but they're quite lovely, beautiful. So now we're going to head upstairs.
And I'm just going to show you the bookcases that are up on the, mezzanine. What would you call that, Tony?
Yeah, I took everything off of there because I didn't want anybody to fall, including myself. This is another one of Melba Moore's picture, and you can see that here she was, this is a watercolor, and the depth and how she was able to make that happen. It's a really neat picture of a church. So the artist, you can see how they grew and learned in their skills. So we'll go this way, Karen. I guess we're calling this the baby room, if you want to call it that. I've got a few vintage baby dolls, some vintage baby clothing. We also have, that goes on some of these dolls, we also have clothes that are probably for about 40 or 50 years ago that have been handmade for the children of this home. So we have quite a bit of it, a little neat chest there that goes with that.
This is really, really cute.
It is, and it's got children's scenes on it, little rabbits. Looks to be probably 30, 40 years old. Really neat. Nice little corner piece. All the beds up here have not really been slept on. These are only frame and mattresses, but the mattresses are in excellent condition. So they didn't have a lot of company that came up here and slept on them. And you can see that when you're looking at the mattresses. So of course we do have a little Christmas, just a tiny bit of Christmas, but the neat piece here is the ceramic Christmas tree that everyone is trying to find. So we have one here that was made probably 30 years ago or so. We have some neat garland and wreaths, and they're all in great shape, so not a whole lot. We do have a baby crib, so any of those folks looking for a baby, Karen? Do you need?
No, I'm good. Oh, okay. I am good.
Just making sure, you know, never know.
Yeah.
These are really neat. These are prints probably early 1800s. They're called Habit. And what they did was they actually did a scene and wrote about the scene and what it was. So we have a total of six of these in this room. So if you're looking for an early piece, and you can see the ink is actually very good on these.
I don't know that it shows very good in this video, but
they are beautiful.
Yeah.
And then we have lots of old sets of books, some pretty neat ones. I do have the poetic works of Sir Walter Scott, and this was 18, let me double check before I tell you that, 1894, and it's in excellent condition. I have a couple of really old, super old books. This desk is for sale. It's a cherry wood, and we do have this. This is the chair's in okay condition. It is vinyl, and it's not leather, so we'll head this way. So we have some neat tapestries throughout the house. Most of those are downstairs. A few of them have moth damage to them. I would say that these were bought out west, handmade by a tribe or an Indian tribe, and they were into that. So these are really beautiful. So if you're collecting that type of art, that would be good to have. We have a king-size bed in here, Like I said, once again, it is certainly a downsizing. This bed is in excellent condition. The mattresses are excellent. A nice little stool. And then we have, I would say, it's almost a mid-century vibe type chest of drawers. So this is neat. A very old trunk that we have there as well. And this is a kind of a neat card table. Needs a little love, some oils put on it, but it's got a really nice inlay on it. Kind of neat. This is for sale. It is a carpet cleaner. So if you have carpet in your house and need a great cleaner, then it's for sale. Now we're going ahead to the basement.
And how many bedrooms does this house have?
One, two, three, I would say four bedrooms. Three on the top level, one on the master on the main.
Or four on the top level if you wanted the office.
Yeah, if you want to consider that as a bedroom, yes.
So five bedroom home. Lord, I'm lost.
She's lost, sorry. Actually, you all will be using these stairs. Please watch your step. There's a little hump right here. You can show them that.
Yep.
I don't want anybody to fall. So we're going to allow you to use it because we're having a checkout inside, so it'll be warm for everyone. So we do have a weed eater. We have
a blower.
A blower that's gas powered, which is cool. You don't have to worry about a cord. Some different pieces down here. A couple of vacuum cleaners. This is kind of wild. So I thought Karen was going to take this home. She likes to drink at night. So I thought this would be really cool for her to have at her bar.
That is for
area.
People that are not ready to let go of summer.
Yeah. Yeah, if you want summer, or you could put Christmas on it and you could call it something from like a Caribbean
Christmas.
Yes. We have
stuff.
Lots of stuff. If you're looking for a power cord, I have them. Quite a few of them. We have some painting supplies here. A few chemicals. Some of those are new.
A few kitchen things.
Yeah. This is one of those savers. You know, that you can wrap
for
your food
for people that cook.
Yeah, that's not you. And then we have a little waffle maker here.
Don't do that either.
Appears to be in good condition. And then just a variety of different things, some electrical pieces. We have quite a few batteries, quite a few items here that are for sale. We tried to organize them all. And you can see here we have some tools on here, some wrenches. Some different things. Well, we have saws, we have hammers.
Guys, he only recognizes a few things. That's
yeah,
the ones
I
he talks about.
This. So anyway, quite a few big tools here. We do have some electrical wiring, electrical cords here. Once again, some hammers, screwdrivers, things like that.
Let's talk about the elephant in the room.
Oh. This is a beautiful, beautiful oak.
It is gorgeous.
Pool table. So if you've been looking for a pool table and you know it's going to be priced well, this is the sale to come to because this pool table is in excellent condition. There's no mars, nothing wrong with the top of it. It has the pool sticks to go with it. We also have the pool stand that we'll be more than happy to take out for you guys to have that for each of your pool sticks. And
as always, bring your friends because
yes,
this baby's heavy.
Yeah, it's not going to be hard to get out of it because we have a garage door down here.
Yeah.
But, you know, we'll have some people here, but this is going to be really heavy to lift. We do where Karen's painting right now. There's some more of those tapestries that were bought. Like I said, a couple of them have moth holes in them, but these are, they're quite lovely. They're beautiful, really. And these are some exercise pieces that we have. These are these really good fold-out chairs. So, and then if you're looking for like a mantle, that TV's for sale as well. If you're looking for like a mantle piece that you can put on your wall, these look like they were made. She may have had them made for her house.
Those are floating shelves.
Yeah, the floating shelves. We have three of those for sale. So I think that's it, Karen. So hopefully everybody can see me. Like I said, it's a downsizing sale. But the quality is here. There are some quantities of some of the items, but like I said, if you're looking for quality items that have been maintained and taken care of, this is a great sale to come to. This sale will start tomorrow from 11 to 5, and then on Friday from 9 to 3, Saturday 8 to 1. And as always, Half Price Day is Saturday. We want to make sure that you be careful parking. Don't park in front of people's driveways or in their landscaping and all that. And like I said, we're opening the downstairs up so that you don't have to be in the cold trying to observe this sale. So please make sure that you are careful going up and down the steps. I think that's it, Karen. Anything else?
Okay, guys. So Tony is doing this sale with our team by himself because I'm in Wise working on another house. So I need y'all to show him a lot of love tomorrow. Because
bring me food.
Yeah, bring him food. That's exactly what I was getting at. Feed him. So anyway, I'll miss you guys, but I'll see you next week in Wise. And I think that's it. Pictures are going to go up sometime today. Soon, I hope. But they will go up sometime this afternoon.
The estate in Wise is huge, by the way. And so we've been working through that all week long. So it's going to take us 2 weeks to get that. So we had to work on this estate at the same time. So anyway, look forward to that. We're going to try to get the pictures up early on the Wise next week so you all can really be mulling them over and looking at them. So thank you again. We look forward to seeing everyone tomorrow.